Every child is a different kind of flower, and all together make this world a beautiful garden. So do you agree that a child is like a unique flower? Each child represents a unique flower, and when there is children, our world is like a beautiful garden. Good day, my name is Myra Yula Sinacario, and I will be reporting about child protection policy in our theories and practices in guidance class in MAED. What is child protection? So do you have an idea what is a child protection? So are we responsible for a child protection? When we say child protection, it refers to programs, services, procedures, and structures that are intended to prevent and respond to abuse, neglect, exploitation, discrimination, and violence among children. So this aims to have a zero tolerance for child abuse, protect children's rights and their best interest, place the child as the first priority when dealing with all identified or suspected cases of child abuse, empower and educate children on their rights, personal safety, and steps they can take if there is a problem, and integrate children protection into all aspects of organizational strategy, structures, and work practices. So this encompasses child protection. So especially in our job as a teacher, we are also responsible in child protection. Are you familiar with the rights of children? So there are different rights of children here in our country, in the Philippines. So what are those rights of children? Based on Presidential Decree No. 603, the Child and Youth Welfare Code, in Article 3, rights of children or rights of the child was mentioned. So it says that all children shall be entitled to the rights herein set forth without distinct as the legitimacy or illegitimacy, sex, social status, religion, political antecedents, and other factors. So regardless of these factors, all children should be entitled of this right. So number one right of children is that every child is endowed with the dignity and worth of a human being from the moment of his conception, as generally accepted in medical parlance, and has therefore the right to be born well. Number two, every child has the right to a wholesome family life that will provide him with love, care and understanding, guidance and counseling, and moral and material security. The dependent or abandoned child shall be provided with the nearest substitute for a home. So, sa number one na right, so right for life ng children or ng isang bata, lahat ay may karapatang mabuhay. Number two, karapatan sa isang maayos na pamilya at tirahan. Number three, right of children, is that every child has the right to a well-rounded development of his personality to the end that he may become a happy, useful, and active member of the society. The gifted child shall be given opportunity and encouragement to develop his special talent. So, hindi dapat dinidiscriminate yung mga gifted or differently able child. The emotionally disturbed or socially maladjusted child shall be treated with sympathy and understanding and shall be entitled to treatment and competent care. The physical or mentally handicapped child shall be given the treatment, education, and care required by his particular condition. So, sa number 3, ito naman binibigyang din dito na dapat pantay-pantay kahit may kapansanan man yung bata. So, dapat mabigyan ng equal opportunity. The fourth rights of children is that every child has the right to a balanced diet, adequate clothing, sufficient shelter, proper medical attention, and all basic physical requirements of a healthy and vigorous life. So, right of needs. Yung mga needs dapat nabibigay sa mga bata. Number 5, every child has the right to be brought up in an atmosphere of morality and rectitude for the enrichment and the strengthening of his character. Number 6, every child has the right to an education commensurate with his abilities and to the development of his skills for the improvement of his capacity for service to himself and to his fellow men. Number 7, every child has the right to full opportunities for safe and wholesome recreation and activities, individual as well as social, for the wholesome use of his leisure hours. Number 8, every child has the right to protection against exploitation, improper influences, hazards, and other conditions or circumstances prejudicial to his physical, mental, emotional, social, and moral development. Number 9, right of child, is that every child has the right to live in a community and a society that can offer him an environment free from pernicious influences and conducive to promotion of his health and the cultivation of his desirable traits and attributes. Number 10, every child has the right to the care, assistance, and protection of the state, particularly when his parents or guardians fail or unable to provide him with his fundamental needs for growth and development and improvement. Number 11, every child has the right to an efficient and honest government that will deepen his faith in democracy and inspire him with the morality of the constituted authorities, both in their public and private lives. And number 12, every child has the right to grow up as a free individual in an atmosphere of peace, understanding, tolerance, and universal brotherhood, and with the determination to contribute his share in the building of the better world. So those are the 12 rights of children stated in our constitution here in the Philippines. So there are legislation and policies surrounding safeguarding children. So those the following: the Children Act of 1989 as amended, the Children and Social Work Act 2017, Keeping Children Safe in Education 2019, Working Together to Safeguard Children 2018, the Education Act 2002, the United Nations Convention on the Rights of the Child 1992, the Equality Act 2010, the Children and Families Act 2014, and the Human Rights Act 1998. So here in the Philippines, there are also existing laws and guidelines, or shall we say legislation, on how to protect or in child protection, okay? So those are the following. So laws on children. We have the Child and Youth Welfare Code, a special protection of children against child abuse, exploitation, and discrimination act, the IRR of RA 7610, an amendment to National International Revenue Code of 1997, Children's Television Act of 1997, Executive Order 184, Series of 1999, Anti-Trafficking in Persons Act of 2003, Anti-Violence Against Women and Their Children Act of 2004, Juvenile Justice and Welfare Act of 2006, the University of Philippines Charter of 2008, Universally Accessible, Cheaper, and Quality Medicine Act 2008, Socialized and Low-Cost Housing Loan Restructuring and Condonation Act of 2008, Environmental Awareness and Education Act of 2008, National Book Development Trust Fund Act, Republic Act Number 9523, Special Program for the Employment of Students or SPES. So these are some of the many existing law that cater child protection here in our country. So I will not discuss one by one this law. We will just focus on a specific policy being implemented by Department of Education. So please bear with me because our topic requires some technical terms which includes like this example, different laws and acts, okay? The main gist of my report is all about DepEd Order Number 40, Series of 2012. So, what is all about this DepEd Order? So, this DepEd Order Number 40, Series of 2012 is entitled DepEd Child Protection Policy, Policy and Guidelines on Protecting Children in School from abuse, violence, exploitation, discrimination, bullying, and other forms of abuse. So, these are the table of contents. We have the general provision, different section. So, we have section 1, the title, short title. Section 2, statement of policy. Section 3, definition of terms. The duties and responsibilities. So, section 4, central office. 5, regional offices. 6, division office or offices. 7, schools. Section 8, duties and responsibilities of school personnel. Section 9, duties and responsibilities of pupils, students, and learners. We also have preventive measures to address children exploitation, violence, discrimination, and bullying, and other acts of abuse. We have Section 11, capacity building of schools officials, personnel, parents, and students. Protective and remedial measure to address child abuse, exploitation, violence, discrimination, bullying, and other acts of abuse. So Section 12, procedures in handling bullying incidents in school. Section 13, implementation of punitive measures. Section 14, other acts of violence or abuse. Rules and procedures in handling child abuse, exploitation, violence, and discrimination cases. So we have until Section 26. So Section 15, prohibited acts. 16, investigation and reporting. 17, jurisdiction. 18, confidentiality. Section 20, complaint against school personnel or official. Section 21, the private school shall submit the report, so annex, to the division office after each school year. And also, we have the referral and assessment of the victims and offenders and other children. Section 22, referral and assessment. And for the miscellaneous provisions, we have the Section 23, duties of private schools. Section 24, separability clause. Section 25, repelling clause. Section 26, effectivity, and the download DepEd Order Number 40, Series of 2012. 2012. So, I know that you're kind of dizzy with the different section and content of this DepEd Order Number 40, but we will go through it even if we have just a limited time. Okay? Just like what I've said, so DepEd Order Number 40, Series of 2012, is all about policy and guidelines on protecting children in school from abuse, violence, exploitation, discrimination, bullying, and other forms of abuse. So let's define different terms. So in this DepEd order, we will encounter the word child. So child refers to any person below 18 years of age or those over but are unable to fully take care of themselves or protect themselves from abuse, neglect, cruelty, exploitation, or discrimination because of a physical or mental disability or condition. According from Republic Act 7610. For purposes of this department order, the term also includes pupils or students who may be 18 years of age or older but are in school. Another term is children in school. Refers to bona fide pupils, students, or learners who are enrolled in the basic education system, whether regular, irregular, transferee, or repeater, including those who have been temporarily out of school, who are in the school or learning centers, premises, or participating in school-sanctioned activities. So, children in school, yung mga estudyante natin, regardless of their age, kung below 18 man yan or above 18 years old. We also have pupil, student, or learner. Means a child who regularly attends classes in any level of the basic education system under the supervision and, how do you read that? Tutelage. So please consult Miriam or Merriam-Webster. Tutelage of teacher or facilitator. Next, we have school personnel. Means the persons singly or collectively working in public or private school. They are classified as follows. So we have school head, refers to the chief executive officer or administrator of public or private school or learning center. We also have other school officials, include other school officers, including teachers, who are occupying supervisory positions or positions of responsibility and are involved in policy formulation or implementation in a school. Another is academic personnel, includes all school personnel who are formally engaged in actual teaching, service, or in research assignments either on a full-time or part-time basis, as well as those who possess certain prescribed academic functions directly supportive of teaching, such as registrars, librarians, guidance counselors, researchers, and other similar persons. They may include school officials who are responsible for academic matters and other school officials. Okay? Other personnel includes all the non-academic personnel in the school, whatever may be the nature of their appointment and status of employment. So, papasok dito yung mga utility natin, mga jobber, guard, pwede dito sa other personnel. Another term that we will encounter is the child protection. So, once we say child protection itself, it refers to program services, procedures, and structures that are intended to prevent and respond to abuse, neglect, exploitation, discrimination, and violence. We also have parents. Parents refers to biological parents, step-parents, adoptive parents, and the common law spouse or partner of the parent. We also have guardians or custodians, refers to legal guardians, foster parents, and other persons including relatives or even non-relatives who have physical custody of the child. Next, we have school visitor or guest, refers to any person who visits the school and has any official business with the school, and any person who does not have any official business but is found within the premises of the school, pati yung mga nagtatambay lang malapit sa school. This may include those who are within the school premises for certain reason, example, student teachers, catechists, service providers, suppliers, bidders, parents and guardians of other children. So we have also child abuse. Child abuse refers to the maltreatment of child, whether habitual or not, which includes any of the following: psychological or physical abuse, neglect, cruelty, sexual abuse, and emotional maltreatment. Another is any act of by deeds or words which debases, degrades, or demeans the intrinsic worth and dignity of child as a human being. So, mga masasamang salita na binibitawan natin kasama rin pala po sa child abuse. Also, unreasonable deprivation of child's basic needs for survival such as food and shelter. So, child abuse din po kung hindi natin bibigyan ng basic needs kagaya ng pagkain ang mga bata. Next, we have failure to immediately give medical treatment to an injured child resulting in serious impairment of his or her growth and development or in the child's permanent incapacity or death. So, according to Section 3, letter B, RA 7610. Discrimination against children. So, it refers to an act of exclusion, distinction, restriction, or preference which is based on any ground such as age, ethnicity, sex, sexual orientation, and gender identity, language, religion, political or other opinion, national or social origin, property, birth, being infected or affected by human immunodeficiency virus and acquired immune deficiency syndrome, AIDS, being pregnant, being a child in conflict with the law, being a child with disability or other status of condition, and which has the purpose or effect of nullifying or impairing the recognition, enjoyment, or exercise by all persons on an equal footing or all rights and freedoms. We also have the term child exploitation. It refers to the use of children for someone else's advantage, gratification, or profit, often resulting in an unjust, cruelty, and harmful treatment of the child. These activities disrupt the child's normal physical or mental health, education, moral, or social-emotional development. It covers situation of manipulation, misuse, abuse, victimization, oppression, or ill treatment. There are two main forms of child exploitation that are recognized. Number one is the sexual exploitation. It refers to the abuse of a position of vulnerability, deferential power or trust for sexual purposes. It includes, but it is not limited to, forcing a child to participate in prostitution or the production of pornographic materials as a result of being subjected to a threat, deception, coercion, abduction, force abuse, or authority, debt, bondage, fraud, and or through abuse of victims' vulnerability. So, may mga kabataan ngayon, mga bata, na pinag-i-engage sa sexual exploitation. Ginagamit yung kanilang kainosentihan, kakulangan sa kaalaman at experience para ilagay sa ganitong posisyon. We also have economic exploitation. Refers to the use of the child in work or other activities for the benefit of others. Economic exploitation involves a certain gain or profit through the production, distribution, and consumption of goods and services. This includes, but is not limited to, illegal child labor as defined in RA 9231. So, yung ibang mga bata, meron po baga tayo na nakikita minsan na pinaglilimos, mga nanlilimos na bata. Pero, yun pala, may mga handlers sila. Iba naman, pinagtatrabaho kahit mga minor de edad pa. Another, we have violence against children committed in schools. Refers to a single act or a series of acts committed by school administrators, academic and non-academic personnel against a child, which result in or is likely to result in physical, sexual, psychological harm or suffering, or other abuses including threats of such acts, battery, assault, coercion, harassment, or arbitrary deprivation of liberty. It includes but is not limited to the following acts. So, masakit man isipin, pero minsan ang mga violence nangyayari din sa school. We have the different kinds of violence. Number one, physical violence refers to acts that inflict bodily or physical harm. It includes assigning children to perform tasks which is hazardous to their physical well-being. So, pag nako-compromise yung physical well-being ng bata, it may include to a physical violence. Say, for example, pinag-chair dance mo yung may mga lifting. So, pwedeng magkaroon ng physical injury yung bata. Another type of violence is sexual violence. So, what is sexual violence? It refers to acts that are sexual in nature. It includes but is not limited to A. Rape, sexual harassment, acts of lasciviousness, making demeaning and sexual suggestive remarks, physically attacking the sexual parts of the victim's body. And letter B. Forcing the child to watch obscene publications and indecent shows, or forcing the child to do indecent sexual acts and or to engage or be involved in the creation or distribution of such films, indecent publication, or material. So, kasama dito sa sexual violence yung sa rape, sexual harassment, yung mga, siguro kasama na rin po dito yung mga pag nagsasabi ka ng mga malalaswang salita sa bata, mga nanghihipo, yung mga mayroon pang iba dyan na nagpapakita ng kanilang private parts. So, sino naman ang hindi yan masasyak? And also, yung mga pinipilit yung bata. Kaya wag na wag po tayo magpapa-movie marathon sa mga bata. Lalo na kung mga tipong 365 days, 50 Shades of Grey. Okay po. And also, mayroon din mga bata or kabataan na i-involve sa mga sex scandal. Okay? So, papasok po yan dito sa sexual violence. Sexual violence also includes acts causing or attempting to cause the child to engage in any sexual activity by force, threat of force, physical or other harm, or threat of physical or other harm or coercion, or through inducements, gifts, or favors. So may mga ganyan na parang sinusuhulan para bumigay yung bata. Yung iba naman talagang pinipilit. So kasama po yan sa sexual violence. And although hindi ko na-experience ang ganito, pero feeling ko po ang maka-experience ng ganito ay napaka-traumatic sa part ng isang musmus na bata. We also have psychological violence. So this refers to acts or omissions causing or likely to cause mental or emotional suffering of the child, such as but not limited to intimidation, harassment, stalking, damage to property, public ridicule or humiliation, deduction or threat of deduction from grade or merit as a form of punishment, and repeated verbal abuse. So, aminin natin, may mga naging teacher tayo, or minsan siguro, personally, nakaka-cause tayo ng psychological harm or violence sa student. Kasi minsan, so sobrang dala na rin siguro ng galit, na ipapahiya natin sila sa classmate nila. Ano pa? Minsan na papunish or nakakapagbitiw tayo ng masasakit na salita. And also minsan yung grade nga, yung sige, bawasan ko ang grade mo. Di ba? May mga ganyan tayo. So, ito pala ay papasok sa psychological violence since magkakaroon ito ng effect sa mental or emotional or emotion ng bata. Pero, yung mga ginagawa naman natin na iba ay mild, kumbaga, out of anger na din, and out of consciousness natin, unconsciously. Okay? So, now that we have background about this, so maybe starting next school year, wala na ako may face-to-face na ay maiwasan natin yung mga ganitong violence. So, we also have other acts of violence, of physical, sexual, or psychological nature that are prejudicial to the best interest of the child. We also have bullying or peer abuse. Refers to willful aggressive behavior that is directed toward a particular victim who may be outnumbered, younger, weak with disability, less confident, or otherwise vulnerable. So itong bullying or peer abuse ay usong-uso sa school ng mga magkakaklase. Ang kadalasang biktima, yung mas bata, mas pitit, mas weak tingnan, o yung may mga disability, yung mga mahihain, at yung mga vulnerable po dito. So, more particularly, bullying is committed when a student commits an act or a series of acts. So, hindi lang isa, kundi minsan palagi, directed towards another student, or a series of single acts directed towards several students in a school setting or a place of learning, which results in physical and mental abuse, harassment, intimidation, or humiliation. Such acts may consist of any one or more of the following. So, yun nga po, usong-usong bullying sa school. Pero as a teacher, kailangan natin itong agapan. Okay po? Sa bullying, it includes threats to inflict a wrong upon the person, honor, or property of the person, or on his or her family. So, may mga ganyan na yung mga nambubuli minsan. Siya na nambuli, ang isusumbong pang nagkamali, yung binuli. So, minsan, sinisira yung gamit ng binubuli, or minsan nadadamay pa yung family. Another, we also have stalking or constantly following or pursuing a person in his or her daily activities with unwanted and obsessive attention. Ito yung mga nagpapapansin. sunod ng sunod, minsan nangyayari to sa mga babae, sinusundan ng mga lalaki kasi nagpapapansin. Okay? We also have taking of property. So, kinukuha yung gamit, parang sabi nga, kagdaag. We also have public humiliation or public and malicious imputation of a crime or a vice versa, a vice or defect, whether real or imaginary, or any act, omission, condition, status, or circumstance tending to cause dishonor, discredit, or expose a person to contempt. So, meron naman pong ibang mga nambubuli na pinapahiya yung isang tao or nagkukos ng malisyosong paratang sa isang tao or sa isang bata. Another na pwede nating ma-incorporate sa bullying is that deliberate destruction or defacement of or damage to the child's property. Kanina na-mention na po ito. Also, physical violence committed upon a student which may or may not result to harm or injury with or without the aid of weapon, such as violence. Such violence may be in the form of mauling, hitting, punching, kicking, throwing things at the student, pinching, spanking, or other similar acts. So, sa bullying, nakakapag-conduct din ng physical violence. Kasi minsan may mga estudyante na nananapak, nanuntok, nandadumpaw, nangungurot. So, minsan, ang iba may weapon pa, tinutusok ng ball, kaya sumatakot na po yan. So, sana pag may face-to-face na wag naman, wala namang ganitong mga incident. And also, we have demanding or requiring sexual or monetary favors or exacting money or property from a pupil or student. So, may mga ganito, yung mga barumbado, mga siga-siga na may hinihinging kapalit, tinatakot yung isang biktima na pag hindi mo yan binigay, ano, bigyan mo ko ng pera, ganun. Okay? We also have restraining the liberty and freedom of a pupil or student. Another, we have cyberbullying. Cyberbullying is any conduct defined in the preceding paragraph as resulting in harassment, intimidation, or humiliation through electronic means or other technology such as but not limited to texting, email, instant messaging, chatting, internet, social networking websites, or other platforms or format. So, itong cyberbullying, parang bullying din, pero ang pinagkaiba lang, nangyayari to, it takes place with the aid, or ito ay nangyayari with the aid of gadgets, electronic means. So, halimbawa, nagbablockmail sa text, sa email, kung ano-anong, nangyayumiliate, nagsasabi ng mga kung ano-anong mga masamang salita. So, that example. Other acts of abuse by a pupil, student, or learner refers to other serious acts of abuse committed by a pupil, student, or learner upon another pupil, student, or learner of the same school, not falling under the definition of bullying in the preceding provisions, including but not limited to acts of physical, sexual, or psychological nature. Next, we will also encounter the word corporal punishment. It refers to the kind of punishment or penalty imposed for an alleged or actual offense which is carried out or inflicted for the purpose of discipline, training, or control by a teacher, school administrator, an adult, or any other child who has been given or has assumed authority or responsibility for punishment or discipline. It includes physical humiliating or degrading punishment, including but not limited to the following. So, meron pa ba nitong corporal punishment sa ngayon? Kasi, very, ano na nga po, student pro ang curriculum, ang ano natin, sistema sa DepEd. Pero, may mga na-record pa rin na ganitong cases na nagkakandak ng corporal punishment sa school. Pero, ito po ay mahigpit ng kinukundi na. So, ano nga ba ang mga kasama sa corporal punishment? So, number one, we have blows such as, but not limited to, beating, kicking, hitting, slapping, or lashing of any part of child's body with or without the use of an instrument such as, but not limited to, cane, broomstick, whip, or belt. So, dati talaga naabot ko pa po ito yung mayroong pamalo si teacher. So, pero ngayon, Diyos ko, ang galit ng teacher, iutot na lang. Kasi sa huli, babalik lang naman sa yung ginawa mo. So, kaya minsan, dahil nga sobrang student pro na yung ating sistema, nagiging, ano na rin, namimihasa na yung mga bata. Another type of corporal punishment is striking a child's face or head, such being declared as a no-contact zone. So, bawal yan kasi baka mapakaraot kung ano mangyari sa bata. So, kayo po, nagawa niyo na ba yan? So far, hindi pa naman kasi bawal na nga. We also have pulling hair, shaking, twisting, joints, cutting, or piercing skin. My God. Dragging, pushing, or throwing of a child. So, sinasabunutan. Iniyuyuga-yuga. Tinitwist yung joints. Grabe. Kawawa naman yung bata. So, next, we also have forcing a child to perform physically painful or damaging acts such as, but not limited to, holding a weight or weights for an extended period and kneeling on a stone, salt, pebbles, and or other objects. So, ito yung mga talang sinauna dati. Pero hindi na natin to ginagawa ngayon, hopefully. We also have deprivation of child's physical needs as a form of punishment. So, minsan may mga gusto ng mag-recess, kumain, or mag-CR. Pero, bawal lumabas. Bawal lumabas. Okay, we also have deliberate exposure to fire, ice, water, smoke, sunlight, rain, pepper, alcohol, or forcing the child to swallow substances, dangerous chemicals, and other materials that can cause discomfort or threaten the child's health, safety, and sense of security, such as but not limited to bleach or insecticides in excrement or urine. Grabe naman to. So, next you also have tying up a child. Tinatali yung bata sa upuan. Sobrang kulit siguro. So, pero hindi naman po siguro natin to ginagawa. Next we have confinement, imprisonment, or depriving the liberty of a child, kinulong sa classroom. Okay, so we have also verbal abuse or assaults, including intimidation or a threat of bodily harm, swearing or cursing, ridiculing or denigrating the child. Sinumpa na yung bata. Next, we have forcing a child to wear a sign, to undress or disrobe, or to put on any that will make a child look or feel foolish, which belittles or humiliates the child in front of others. Pinag-costume nga, kunwari, pinag-make-upan ng katawa-tawa, so kasama po pala yun sa corporal punishment. 11, permanent confiscation of personal property of pupils, students, or learners, except when such pieces of property pose a danger to the child or to others. So, ang ano po kaya pag-confiscate ng cellphone during class hours. So, meron po baga kasi ngayon kasi masyado nang maluwag ang sistema natin. So, ang ibang mga bata nag-cellphone. Pero, pag naman daw po yung i-confiscate natin ay magkakos ng danger sa child, okay lang naman yun. Pero ang cellphone ba? Next, other analogous acts. We also have positive and non-violent discipline of children. It is a way of thinking and holistic, constructive, and proactive approach to teaching that helps children develop appropriate thinking and behavior in the short and long term and fosters self-discipline. It is based on the fundamental principle that children are full human beings with basic human rights. Positive discipline begins with setting the long-term goals or impacts the teachers want to have on their students' adult lives and using everyday situations and challenges as opportunities to teach lifelong skills and values to students. So, ito naman yung kabaligtaran ng mga corporal punishments. So, we have the positive and non-violent discipline of children. Mga constructive criticism, mga ganun po. Proactive approach. So, we come now to duties and responsibilities. So, mahaba-haba po itong report. So, please bear with me. May mga slides tayong lalaktawan kasi medyo ano naman na po. Kumbaga, papahapyawan lang natin. Okay? So, duties and responsibilities, section 4. So, sa central office, the DepEd central office shall have the following duties and responsibilities. So, ito po yung mga duties and responsibilities ng central office. So, develop a policy and guidelines. Kagaya po nito, nag-develop sila ng DepEd Order number 40 series of 2012. So, conduct a nationwide information dissemination and campaign. So, ayan po. We also have devise program campaigns and activities through the offices of the undersecretary. So, ayan po. Yan ang duties and responsibilities ng central office. They also formulate a system of standard reporting. So, mga annex-annex, yung mga template. Paano, para po mas madali yung pag, ano po ng data. And the secretary shall exercise disciplinary jurisdiction. So, ayan po. Hindi ko na po masyadong bibigyan ng emphasis kasi po, din na lang po tayo mag-focus sa pagsa-school na. Next, we also have duties and responsibilities ng regional office. So, ito naman po ang responsibilities and duties ng regional office. So, galing kay central office, si regional office encourage and support the advocacy campaigns and capability building activities on prevention of child abuse violence. So, ayan po. Dapat supportahan nila yun kasi nanggaling na sa central office. Also, consolidate reports. Ayan po. Monitor and evaluate the implementation. Exercise disciplinary jurisdiction. Also, give recommendation to central office. So, kung mayroon napansin na pwedeng idagdag para mas magpaganda yung program, pwede rin po mag-recommend ang regional office. Next, we have the division offices. So, ano naman po ang duties and responsibilities ng division office? So, conduct the information dissemination. So, nagpapalabas na ng mga memorandum. So, ayan po. Advocacy campaigns, ayan po, apply positive and non-violent discipline, formulate, implement guidelines and procedure, provide conflict resolution and peer mediation. organize and conduct the capacity building. So, ayan po, develop strategies to address the risk factors and contribute to the commission of acts. Okay? Consolidate reports. Monitor and evaluate the implementation, syempre. Exercise disciplinary jurisdiction. Give recommendation to regional office. So, pa-recommend lang. Kasi, galing kay division. Kasi daman po, kung ano naman po yung binibigay ng central office, base rin yan sa outcome and sa mga narisa or sabi nga, na kitang butas or pagkukulang po or pwedeng idagdag pa coming from the lower sections. Utilize resources, encourage support of activities and campaign, perform such other functions. Next, schools. Ano naman po ang duties and responsibilities ng schools? So, ensure the institution of effective child protection policy and procedure and monitor compliance thereof. So, mayroon na po ba tayong mga child protection policy sa kada school? So, minsan, sobrang kabisihan na natin sa mga paperworks, na, lalo na nung nagkaroon ng pandemic kasi wala namang face-to-face, na disregard itong child protection na to, okay? So, also ensure that the school adopt a child protection policy. Ensure that all pupils, students, or learners, school personnel, parents, guardians, or custodians, and visitors, and guests are made aware of child protection policy. Likewise, organize and convene the Child Protection Committee for school. Conduct the capacity building activities for the members of the Child Protection Committee and guidance counselors or teachers. So, dapat po meron na tayong Child Protection Committee. And also, conduct disciplinary proceeding in cases of offenses committed by pupils, students, and learners. And ensure that the participatory and other rights of children are respected and upheld in all matters and procedures affecting their welfare. Also, maintain a record of all proceedings related to bullying or peer abuse and submit after each the school year to division office. So, dapat po pala may mga record tayo ng mga nangyayaring kababalaghan ng mga nangyayaring violence like bullying or abuse sa ating school na dapat pinu-forward natin sa division office after during each school year. So we also conduct the appropriate training and capability building activities on child protection measures and protocols. And letter J, ensure that the school adopts a student code of conduct to be followed by every pupil. So, dapat may code of conduct tayo or learner na pinafollow ng mga student while on school grounds. So, may mga sa student handbook, kumbaga natin nakalagay naman yan. Kumbaga yan yung kanilang Bible pag nasa school, yung kanilang guide. Adopt such conflict resolution mechanisms that respect the rights of indigenous people. So, yung ating mga IPs, dapat meron pong, kumbaga, pinagbibigyan din ng pansin dito sa responsibility din po ito ng school. Next, coordinate with the appropriate offices. So, ano pong mga offices yan? Or agencies, kagaya ng DSWD, PNP, okay? Coordinate with Department of Social Welfare, ito na nga po. Appropriate government agencies, non-government organization, child protection hotline for reporting abuse, violence, ito po, okay? Ensure that all incidents of abuse, violence, exploitation, discrimination, bullying, and other similar acts are addressed in accordance with the provision of department order. So, yan po ang mga duties and responsibilities ng school. ano naman po yung mga duties and responsibility ng school personnel? So, sa Article 218 of Family Code of the Philippines, provides the following responsibilities of school administrators, teachers, academic and non-academic, and other personnel. First, exercise special parental authority. So, we are the second parent. Pag nasa school, tayo ang magulang ng mga bata. And responsibility over the child while under their supervision, instruction, and custody. Authority and responsibility shall apply to all authorized activities, whether inside or outside the premises of school, entity, or institution. Articles 220 and 233 of Family Code of the Philippines, Presidential Decree Number 603, and other related laws enumerated the following duties and responsibilities of the above mentioned persons and personnel over the children under their supervision, instruction, and custody. So, base po sa Decree Number 603. So, we have keep them in their company and support, educate, and instruct them by right precept and good example. So, as a teacher, as a school personnel, kailangan daw natin na i-educate, i-support, at magbigay ng instruction sa mga bata ng naaayon, okay, yung tama at good example po. Also, give them love and affection, advice and counsel, companionship and understanding. So, hindi lang dapat yung kanilang IQ yung tinifeed natin, kundi we also have to provide or make them feel love of, and yun nga, dapat we act as parang yung magulang talaga nila. So, kung pwede nga, magbigay tayo ng mga advices and kailangan rin natin silang intindihin. Also, enhance, protect, preserve, and maintain their physical and mental health at all times. So, another ano po ito natin, duties and responsibilities, nagprotektahan, nalinangin, preserve at maintain ang kanilang physical and mental health. Furnish them with good and wholesome education materials, supervise their activities, recreation, and association with others. Protect them from bad company and prevent them from acquiring habits detrimental to their health, studies, and morals. And represent them in all matters affecting their interest. Also, inculcate the value of respect and obedience. So, ito minsan nagkukulang na sa mga bata ngayon. Masyado na silang hindi naman sa walang respeto, pero kumbang hindi kagaya ng dati. Pero ito ay, yun nga, babalik pa rin sa atin kasi ito po ay duties and responsibilities natin. Next, practice positive and non-violent discipline as may be required under the circumstances, provided that in no case shall corporal punishment be inflicted upon them. So, dapat walang corporal punishment. Doon lang tayo sa positive and non-violent discipline. Also, perform such other duties as are imposed by law upon them. As substitute parents or guardians and school personnel shall also strictly comply with the school's child protection policy. So, ano naman, kung mayroon mga duties ang school personnel, ano naman po ang duties and responsibilities ng pupils, students, and learners? Alangan man lagi lang sila ang pinapaboran, diba? So, mayroon din po silang duties and responsibilities. Pupils, students, and learners shall have the following duties and responsibilities. Comply with school's regulations as long as they are in harmony with their best interest. Pupils, students, and learners shall refrain from engaging in discrimination or leading a group of pupils or students to discriminate another with reference to one's physical appearance, weaknesses and status of any sort. So, kung meron tayong rights, dapat meron din, may kaakip din yan na responsibilidad. So, ang responsibilidad ng estudyante natin ay sumunod sa mga regulation ng school. Another responsibility and duties of students is doing any act that is inappropriate or sexually proactive. I mean, not doing. So, wag po tayong mga bata, dapat wag na wag magagawa ng ganito, okay? Also, participating in behavior of other students that is illegal, unsafe, or abuse. So, dapat iwasan po ito. Mga ibang mga bata, nagka-cutting class, nag-iinuman, di ba mga ganyan, nagsisigarilyo, so bawal. Lalo na kung nasa school or sa school premises pa po. Pero bawal na talaga. And then, marking or damaging school properties, vandalism, including books, in any way. So, no po sa vandalism. Also, engaging in fights or any aggressive behavior. Marungba daw. So, hindi rin po yan allow. Hindi nyo yan duties and responsibilities, kundi dapat nyo po yan iwasan as a student. Introducing into the school premises or otherwise possessing prohibited articles such as deadly weapons, drugs, alcohol, toxic and nauseous substances, cigarettes, pornographic material. So, bawal din po niyan magdala ang mga estudyante. Mga ganito. So, weapon. Kasi malay mo biglang mag-riot. Lalo na po ang drugs, ang alcohol, mga toxic substance, cigarettes, at yung mga pornographic material. Pero minsan itong sa pornographic material, may nakalulusot kasi yung mga Android na ang cellphone. We also have performing other similar acts that can cause damage or injury to another. So, an allegation that any of these acts has been committed shall not be used to curtail the child's basic rights or interpreted to defeat the objectives of this department order. Conduct themselves in accordance with their level. So, another duties and responsibilities po ng mga bata ay ng mga estudyante, conduct themselves in accordance with their levels of development, maturity, and demonstrated capabilities with a proper regard for the rights and welfare of other persons. Respect another person's rights, regardless of opinion, status, gender, ethnicity, religion, as well as everyone's moral and physical integrity. So, equal opportunity. Dapat respect po. And also observe the code of conduct of pupils, students, and learners. In section 10, establishment of child protection committee. So, dapat po pala ang school ay mayroong child protection committee. Kaya sa school niyo po ba meron ng mga ganito? Sa amin ka po kasi hindi pa nakapag-establish since nag-pandemic and ang school namin ay hindi pa naman masyadong matagal po. Pero hopefully in the coming years, lalo na next school year, ay magkaroon na po nitong Child Protection Committee kasi nga po para makapag-comply tayo doon sa DepEd order na ito. So, all public and private elementary and secondary schools shall establish a Child Protection Committee. So, it is a must to have CPC. So, sino po ba ang nagko-compose ng CPC? So, CPC is composed of the following person, or ito po ang nagko-compose sa CPC or Child Protection Committee. We have the school head or administrator as chairperson, guidance counselor or teacher, kung sino po, guidance coordinator designate as vice chairperson. We also have representative of the teachers as designated by the faculty club. Representative of the parents as designated by the Parents Teacher Association or the GPTA. Representative of pupils, students, and learners as designated by SSC or the SSG, Supreme Student Council. and representative from the community as designated by the punong barangay, preferably a member of the Barangay Council for the Protection of Children or BCPC. So, ito po pala dapat ang bumubuo sa ating Child Protection Committee. So, hindi lang siya we also have the CPC shall perform the following function. Draft school child protection policy with a code of conduct and a plan to ensure child protection and safety, which shall be reviewed every 3 years. The template for school child protection policy is already attached in the Annex C. Okay? We also have initiate information. So, ang CPC din po ay dapat mag-initiate ng information dissemination programs and organized activities for the protection of children from abuse, exploitation, violence, discrimination, and bullying and peer abuse. CPC should also develop and implement a school-based referral and monitoring system. May template na din po sa referral system sa Annex D. And also, establish a system for identifying students who may be suffering from significant harm based on any physical, emotional, or behavioral signs. Identify, refer, and appropriate report to the appropriate offices cases involving child abuse, exploitation, violence, discrimination, and bullying. Give assistance to parents or guardians whenever necessary in securing expert guidance, counseling from the appropriate offices or institutions. Another duty of CPC is to coordinate closely with the Women and Child Protection Desk in the Philippine National Police, the local Social Welfare and Development Offices or LSWDO, other government agencies and non-government organizations, NGOs, as may be appropriate. Also, monitor the implementation of positive measures and effective procedures in providing the necessary support for the child and for those who care for the child. And ensure that the children's right to be heard are respected and upheld in all matters and procedures affecting their welfare. So, ito po yung mga duties and responsibilities ng CPC. So, medyo mabigat-bigat kung makasama tayo sa ganitong or ma-appoint tayo dito sa as member of CPC. Pero, yun nga po, since ito ay para sa welfare ng mga estudyante, so it is also fulfilling sa part natin. We come now to the preventive measure to address child abuse, exploitation, violence, discrimination, and bullying and other acts of abuse. So, sa Section 11, capacity building of schools, officials, personnel, parents, and students. So, all public and private elementary and secondary schools shall build the capacities of school personnel, pupils, students, and learners, parents, and guardians to understand and deal with child abuse, exploitation, violence and discrimination cases, bullying and peer violence by conducting sessions, trainings and seminars on positive peer relationship and enhancement of social and emotional competence. So, dapat po pala nagkakandak tayo ng mga pa-training, ng mga seminar about dito po sa child protection policy. Hindi lang sa mga teacher, pati sa mga guardian and parents, sa students, pati na rin sa mga stakeholders. They shall use training modules which include positive and nonviolent discipline and classroom management, anger and stress management, and gender sensitivity. They shall likewise employ means which enhance the skills and pedagogy in integrating and teaching children's right in the classroom. So, may mga modules na rin, training modules din po pala ito. The programs that are intended to promote positive and nonviolent discipline include but not limited to the following. Number one, integration of education sessions on corporal punishment and positive discipline in the initiatives of the Parent-Teacher Association. So, Number two, capacity building programs for school administrators, teachers, and non-academic personnel focus on children's rights, child development, and positive nonviolent approaches in teaching and classroom. Management to enable them to incorporate positive discipline messages in parent-teacher conferences and family counseling and integrate messages on children's rights and corporal punishment in classroom discussion. Number three, encouraging and supporting the formation and initiatives of support groups among teaching and non-teaching staff and parents and caregivers. Number four, implementing specific parenting orientation sessions with parents and caregivers and other activities. We also have implementing school activities or events that raise awareness on children's rights, corporal punishment, positive discipline, fostering the active involvement of and providing venues for bringing together parents, families, and children. And number six, encouraging and supporting student-led initiatives to raise awareness on children's rights, corporal punishment, and positive discipline, and setting up child-friendly mechanisms for obtaining children's views and participation in the formulation, monitoring, assessment of school rules and policies related to student discipline. So, ito po yung mga pwede nating gawin or ano po ng capacity building mga pa-seminar. So, pwedeng dito umikot po. Okay? Next, protective and remedial measures to address child abuse, exploitation, violence, discrimination, bullying, and other acts of abuse. In Section 12, Procedures and Handling Bullying Incidents in Schools. So, paano nga ba natin ito ma-handle itong bullying sa school? A complaint for bullying or peer abuse shall be acted upon by school head following the procedures here in set forth. So, bullying, upon the filing of complaint or upon notice by a school personnel or official of any bullying or peer abuse incident, the same shall be immediately reported to school head. Dapat i-report agad kay school head, who shall inform the parents or guardian of the victim. So, siya pala dapat po ang mag-i-inform sa guardian ng, or parents ng victim and the offending child at ng biktima. In a meeting called for the purpose, so yan po pala ang tawag sa meeting, meeting for a purpose. The victim and the offending child shall be referred to the Child Protection Committee for counseling. So, ka-counseling po yung dalawa ng member ng CPC and other interventions. The penalty, reprimand, if warranted, may be imposed by the school head in the presence of the parents and guardian. So, pwede po tayo magkaroon ng penalty. Pwede magbigay ng penalty si school head, pero dapat nandyan yung presensya ng parents or guardian. If bullying is committed for a second or subsequent time, so inulit, hindi lang isang beses, after the offending child has received counseling or other intervention, the penalty of suspension for not more than 1 week may be imposed by the school head. So, kung inulit po after nabigyan na nga ng intervention at ng counseling, inulit pa rin, pwede daw pong bigyan ni school head ng 1 week suspension yung offender. During the period of suspension, the offending child and the parents or guardians may be required to attend further seminars and counseling. So, hindi naman pala tatambay sa bahay habang suspended. Pwede pong mag-attend ng seminars and counseling. The school head shall likewise ensure that the appropriate interventions, counseling, and other services are provided for the victim or victims of bullying. So, hindi lang po yung nambiktima ang ika-counseling, pati na din po yung na-victim ng bullying. Bullying that results in serious physical injuries or death. So, medyo ano po ito, crucial. Paano kaya po ito? So, if the bullying or peer abuse resulted in serious physical injuries or death, whenever appropriate, the case shall be dealt with in accordance with the provision of Republic Act 9344 and its implementing rules and regulations. So, ito ang susundin po natin kung ganito na po ang nangyari. Next, we have procedure. In all cases where the imposable penalty on the offending child is suspension, exclusion, or expulsion, the following minimum requirement of due process shall be complied with. The child and the parents or guardian must be informed. So, dapat inform po ng complaint in writing. Nadadala. Also, the child shall be given the opportunity to answer the complaint in writing with the assistance of the parents or guardian. So, pwede niya pong sagutin yung letter of complaint nung bata, yung ng biktima, with the assistance of her or his parents or guardian. The decision of the school head must be in writing. So, dapat laging sa writing may black and white copy or hard copy for documentation purposes na din po. Stating the facts and the reason for the decision. Also, the decision of the school head may be appealed as provided in existing rules of the department. Section 13, implementation of non-punitive measures. Depending on the gravity of the bullying committed by any pupil, student, or learner, the school may be imposed other non-punitive measures in lieu of punitive measures in accordance with the principles of positive and non-violent discipline. So, pwede rin po tayong mag-impose ng non-punitive measures sa mga nakakumit ng bullying. So, ano-ano kaya ito? So, Section 14, other acts of violence or abuse. Other serious acts of violence or abuse committed by a pupil, student, or learner upon another pupil, student, or learner of the same school shall, and whenever appropriate, be dealt with in accordance with the provisions of Republic Act 9344 and its implementing rules and regulations. So, kindly have time po to just visit Google and know more about Republic Act 9344. Next, we have rules and procedures in handling child abuse, exploitation, violence, and discrimination cases. Section 15, prohibited acts. The following acts, as defined in Section 3 of this order, are hereby prohibited and shall be penalized in administrative proceedings as grave of simple misconduct depending on the gravity of the act of its consequences under existing laws, rules, and regulation. So we have child abuse, discrimination against children, child exploitation, violence against children in school, corporal punishment, any analogous or similar acts. Section 16, investigation and reporting. The conduct of investigation and reporting of cases of child abuse, exploitation, violence, or discrimination shall be done expeditiously as herein provided. So, in public school, the school head or school division superintendent, upon receipt of the complaint, shall forward the same within 48 hours to disciplining authority, who shall then issue an order for the conduct of a fact-finding investigation not later than 72 hours from submission. This period shall be strictly observed except when justified by circumstances beyond their control, provided that if the person complained of is non-teaching personnel, the school's division superintendent shall cause the conduct of a fact-finding investigation within the same period. So, kung ang isang school personnel po ay nakagawa ng mga nabanggit kanina, mga pang-aabuso, hindi naman kaagad pinapatawan ng sentensya. Nagkakaroon pa naman po ng fact-finding investigation. If a complaint is not sufficient in form, the concerned school head, school division superintendent, or disciplining authority shall immediately inform the complainant of the requirements of formal complaint. Upon the filing of formal complaint, the same shall be acted upon pursuant to preceding paragraph. So, kailangan po ng mga, may mga requirement din po pag nagko-complain ng mga ganitong acts of abuses para po mag-push through yung inyong reklamo. Okay? The conduct of fact-finding investigation shall be in accordance with the revised rules of procedures of the Department of Education in administrative cases. So, pending investigation upon referral of the school principal or guidance counselor or teacher, the local social welfare and development officer of the concerned local government unit shall assess the child and provide psychosocial intervention to help the child victim recover from whatever trauma he or she has experienced as a result of abuse. The offender shall likewise undergo psychosocial intervention if such is warranted. If a prima facie case exists based on the investigation report and the records, a formal charge shall be issued by the disciplining authority, which may be the basis for the issuance of an order of preventive suspension or as an alternative reassignment of the offending party, as may be warranted. The respondent may be placed under preventive suspension pending investigation for a period of 90 days. So, kung may involve pala tayo dito sa ganitong case, pwede po tayo magkaroon ng suspension of 90 days. But if the injury or abuse committed against a child is so grave as to render the child unable to attend his or her classes, the respondent may also be preventively suspended to preclude the possibility of influencing or intimidating witnesses. The respondent may file a motion for reconsideration with disciplining authority or may elevate the same to the Civil Service Commission by way of appeal within 15 days from receipt thereof. So, napaka-complicated po. So, malapit na po tayong matapos, okay? About sa child protection policy, very wide po kasi ang scope nito. So, may mga technical terms din na dapat medyo mahirap i-explain as a teacher, need ng legal advices kagaya ng mga lawyer, graduate ng law. Pero, yun nga po, para maiwasan na lang po natin ang mga ganitong situation, wag na lang po tayong mag-commit or mag-engage sa ganito pong pang-aabuso. Kasi nga, as a second parent, dapat tayo po ay nag-guide sa mga estudyante. Okay? The revised rules of procedure of Department of Education in administrative cases shall apply in all other aspects. A complaint for education-related sexual harassment as defined under Resolution Number 01-0940 of Civil Service Commission must be in writing, signed, and worn to by complainant it shall contain the following: full name and address of the complainant, full name and address and position of the respondent, brief statement of relevant facts, evidence in support of the complainant, a certification of non-forum shopping. The complainant shall be referred to the Committee on Decorum and Investigation. Upon receipt of the complainant, the committee shall require the person complained of to submit his or her counter-affidavit comment, which shall be under oath not later than 3 days from receipt of the notice, furnishing the complainant a copy thereof. Otherwise, the counter-affidavit of comment shall be considered as not filed. And the procedure of the conduct of the investigation and all other related incidents shall be in accordance with the rules under Resolution Number 01-0940 of Civil Service Commission, provided that if the respondent is a teacher, the composition of the formal investigating committee shall be in accordance with Section 9 of RA 4670. The regional director shall periodically monitor and keep a record of the reported child abuse cases and submit a final consolidated regional report. Failure to submit an incident report to render a decision involving the case within the prescribed period without justifiable cause shall be a ground for administrative action for neglect of duty against the responsible official. And the Office of the Undersecretary for Legal and Legislative Affairs shall compile the regional reports and submit an annual report to Secretary. So, ang grabe pala ang procedure. So, yun nga po. Para maiwasan na lang po ito, so do not engage in abusing our children, our students. So hindi tayo yung dapat maging kalaban nila, kundi dapat kakampi nila tayo laban sa mga ganitong bagay. Okay po? Section 17, Jurisdiction. Complaints of child abuse, violence, discrimination, exploitation, bullying, and other acts of abuse under this department order shall be within the exclusive jurisdiction of the department and shall not be brought for amicable settlement before the barangay, subject or existing laws, rules, and regulations. Complaints for acts committed by a person not under the jurisdiction of the disciplinary authority of the department shall be referred to the appropriate authorities. For Section 18, Confidentiality, in child abuse, violence, discrimination, exploitation, bullying or peer abuse, and other acts of abuse by a pupil, student, or learners, the identity or other information that may reasonably identify the pupil, student, or learner, whether victim or offender, shall be withheld from the public to protect his or her privacy. So, dapat po confidential yung information nung mga involved dito sa ganito pong incident, yung victim and yung offender. On the other hand, the Magna Carta for Public School Teachers protects the rights of teachers, and no publicity shall be given to any disciplinary action against a teacher during the pendency of his or her case. So, kung sa teacher naman po ang na-involve, so mayroon tayong Magna Carta. Pero yun nga po, minsan ang balita ang ipakpak. Kaya kahit na anong lihim, minsan walang lihim na hindi nabubunyag. Yun po, lumalabas pa rin po yung issue. Kaya wag na lang po gumawa ng issue para safe. Okay po? Section 19, Criminal and Civil Liability. Criminal and civil liability arising from child abuse, discrimination, exploitation, and other acts of abuse are separate and distinct and shall not be a bar to the filing of an administrative case under this guidelines. Private schools, so although karamihan sa atin ay nasa public school na, so sa private school, sa section 20, complaint against school personnel or official, a complaint for child abuse, violence, exploitation, or discrimination in private school shall be filed with the school head, chief executive officer, and shall be acted upon pursuant to the school's rules of procedures on administrative cases. So, iba po yung procedure po ng public school sa private school. The penalty shall be that which is provided by the rules of the school, subject to the requirements of due process. The administrative case shall be without prejudice to any civil or crime case that may be filed. For Section 21, the private school shall submit the report Annex A to the division office after each school year. Referral and assessment of victims and offenders and other children. Section 22, referral and assessment. In all cases involving child abuse, violence, exploitation, discrimination, bullying, and other acts of abuse, the CPC or the, Child Protection Committee shall accomplish the intake sheet or Annex B. The school head may refer the victim and offenders in cases involving child abuse, exploitation, discrimination, bullying, and peer abuse, and other acts of abuse to the LSWDO for assessment. And LSWDO shall determine the appropriate intervention. The school head, with the aid of the assigned guidance counselor, teachers, or teacher, in coordination with the LSWDO, shall immediately remove the victim or, in appropriate cases, the offender from the place of the incident. If the victim is determined to be at risk, the child's family shall be informed of any action taken. The school head may also refer to the LSWDO other pupils, students, or learners who are victims of abuse at home, children at risk, children in especially difficult circumstances, children with special needs or at risk, children facing difficulty situations, or those who are exhibiting signs of aggressive behavior with a view to obtaining professional assessment, appropriate intervention, and assistance from competent service provider. So, kung hindi na kayang i-handle ng school head na together with the guidance counselor, pwede pong i-refer ni school head yung mga ganitong cases sa LSWDO or DSWD for further assessment and assistance na rin po. Okay? We have the miscellaneous provisions. Ayan, malapit na po sa wakas. So, after 1.5 hours. So, this and this section 23, duties of private schools. So, private schools shall be responsible for promulgating a school child protection policy, including a policy on bullying, a protocol for reporting, and procedure for handling and management of cases consistent with the policies and guidelines. Section 24, separability clause. Any part of provision of this department order which may be held invalid or unconstitutional shall not affect the validity and effectivity of the other provisions. For Section 25, repelling clause, all prior department orders or other issuances or provisions thereof which are inconsistent with this department order are hereby repelled, revised, or modified accordingly. And Section 26, last effectivity. So, this department order shall take effect immediately upon issuance. So, ito po ay nangyari in-issue pa noong 2012. So, almost decade na na nag-exist po and in-implement po itong DepEd order na ito. So, thank you so much po for listening. Medyo mahabang topic. So let me leave you a quote about children. So, children are the world's most valuable resource and its best hope for the future, according to John F. Kennedy. So, do you believe in this quote? Yes, very, very true. So, children are precious, so we must take care of them, love them. Dahil sabi nga ni Kat Jose Rizal, ang kabataan ay ang pag-asa ng bayan. So, these are my references. So, I don't have the book. I consulted Google. So, these are the links where I get the information included in my report. Yay! Thank you for listening. Hope you learned something. And again, I am Mayra Yula Capistrano Nacario, your reporter for today. Thank you so much, and hopefully you learn, and not just learn, but also understand the lengthy topic I have, and also practice and apply what you have learned comes next school year. Pero wag lang po yung ano, wag lang tayo mag-engage doon sa mga pang-aabuso. Okay? So, have a good day. God bless.